So we are in Radiator Springs, and we're hopefully going to ride the Cars ride, which looks pretty outstanding. Some sort of garlic aioli for the top of it. Oh man, that's really setting it off. He's got like pepper jack cheese or something in it. Oh my god. That's awesome. I'm aware of it.
Monorail in the very back car because Howie apparently knows the secret password. It's just us, which is a little weird. It's very romantic.
My friend Chris here, he needs to become a man. And a way of becoming said man.
That's weird.
Is every man needs his own lightsaber.
Really?
So, my
what?
Best friend here purchased you a
said
lightsaber filled for
Dude.
Christmas. So you can actually become a man.
That's actually very extravagant. You sure about that?
Indeed.
So, that was a very nice surprise. We are waiting to go in. I've got my pen to build my saber. It's apparently a rite of passage. And I'm very excited about becoming a man, you know. I've heard a lot of good things about it. I've been a boy a long time. But now I'm going to be a man. So.
Yep. As gathered, we have traveled throughout this galaxy from abandoned outposts on the edge of the Outer Rim to fallen starships long forgotten by time. This, the lightsaber. His young apprentice, Anakin Skywalker, and our spark of hope, Rey. Green Kyber Crystal. Qui-Gon Jinn, Ahsoka Tano, yes. Master Yoda. And Rey. The Kyber Crystal of power. Darth Maul, Asajj Ventress, Darth Vader. Today, it's wielded by Kylo Ren. Let's build. It chooses its will. I say let it.
To go into the cantina. We gotta get Howie something to eat. Angry Howie. He's glary Howie. He's very glary. Damn moisture evaporators. Well, they are closing down the park. We're all making our way out. It was, again, another magical day at Disney. Highlights were definitely the lightsaber build. And I don't know, I thought it was interesting, the Star Wars lands are literally identical. Which, again, amazing. Don't get me wrong, I would never take anything away from Star Wars Land. It's a magical place. But it seems like with all the different worlds they could have done two different ones at two different parks. Just like there's Sleeping Beauty's castle here and Cinderella's castle in Florida. It just seems like it would have been a cool opportunity to do a different land for Star Wars Land than the Black Spire Outpost. But again, awesome. When you go there, just the sounds, the ambience, every detail that you see, it's breathtaking. There's no other word to describe it. It's just an amazing place. But had a great time, and definitely hope to come back again soon. See you later.